हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। दिस इज द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ योर इंग्लिश बुक एंड बुक नेम इज विस्टास। वन थिंग आई वांट टू मेंशन हियर दैट आई स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द लेसन सेकंड बिकॉज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन इज नॉट इन योर सिलेबस दिस ईयर। दैट्स व्हाई आई स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम दिस लेसन। सो द स्टोरी इज अबाउट टेकिंग ऑफ द ओल्डन टाइम एंड ही वॉज कॉल्ड द टाइगर किंग। ऑल्दो ही हैड अ वेरी लॉन्ग लॉन्ग नेम बिकॉज ही हैज गिवन सो मच टाइटल एंड इफ यू एट देम ऑल द वर्ल्ड which will come forward the tiger. So that's why he was called the Tiger King. So this story is written by the writer Kalki. So the full name of the writer is Ramaswamy Iyer Krishnamurthy, and he is a South Indian writer and was a Tamil writer, journalist, poet, critic and Indian independence activist also. He wrote more than 120 short stories, novels and etc. So here is a story written by him and the name of the story is the Tiger King. So this story is a satire, a kind of humor, satire means, on the rich and powerful kings of the olden time. In order to prove the prophecies of the fortune teller wrong, the king of Pratibandhampuram mindlessly kills 99 tiger, but the 100th one, the cause of the king's death, escapes his bullet. Ultimately, the king is killed by an animate tiger made of wood, hence the prophecy turns to be true, despite the king's effort to prove it wrong. Now let's see the story of this lesson. So the Maharaja of Pratibandhampuram, Pratibandhampuram, the place of the kingdom the king belongs, is the hero of this story. He may be identified as His Highness Zimedar General, Killedar Major, Shat Vyagras संहारी महाराजा धीराजा विश्व भुवना सम्राट सर जिले लानी जंग बहादुर MAD ACTE एंड CRCK, बट दिस नेम इज ऑफन शॉर्टेंड टू द टाइगर किंग। सो बेसिकली द राइटर इंट्रोड्यूस द मेन कैरेक्टर ऑफ द स्टोरी, द किंग ऑफ प्रतिबंधमपुरम। द किंग इज अ हीरो ड्यू टू हिज ब्रेवरी। ही इज गिवन ए लिस्ट ऑफ टाइटल्स, मीन्स ही हैज गिवन ए सो मेनी टाइटल्स एज यू कैन see mentioned above, and due to his bravery he is given a list of titles to emphasize on his greatness, to show his greatness. If you sum up all the titles of the king is called the Tiger King. The reason for him being called so shall be revealed in this lesson ahead. So what is the reason that he has given so much title is you will know ahead in this story. I have often come forward to tell you why he came to be known as Tiger King. I have no intention of pretending to advance only to end in a strategic withdrawal. Even the threat of a Stuka bomber will not throw me off track. The Stuka, if it like, can bait a hasty retreat from my story. So the writer tells us that He will tell us why the king was called the Tiger King, means what is the reason that he has given so much titles. It is the main aim of the writer that he will tell us all. He further promises the reader that he will not go back on his promise even if he is under the threat of an attack by a Stuka bomber. Aircraft can go back because he is not scared of it, and he will tell the reader why the king was called the Tiger King, because the writer of this chapter, he has determined to tell the writer that what the circumstances came forward. He will definitely tell the writer, reader, what is the reason behind the king that he has given so many titles. Right at the start, it is imperative to disclose a matter of vital importance about the Tiger King. Everyone who reads of him will experience the natural desire to meet a man of his indomitable courage face to face, but there is no chance of its fulfillment. As Bharata said to Rama about Dashratha, the king has reached that final abode of and all living creatures, in other words, the tiger is dead. So the writer says that before elaborating about the Tiger King, one important thing about him was that any person who read about the Tiger King would be very excited to meet a man of such indefatigable courage. But he says that there is no chance of meeting the Tiger King, as the Tiger King is already dead and he has reached heaven. So a kind of satire is created in this line, because a person of whom the writer is describing, he has already dead. The manner of his death is a matter of extraordinary interest. It can be revealed only at the end of the tale. The most fantastic aspects of his demise was that as soon as he was born, astrologers had foretold that one day the Tiger King would actually have to die. So basically in this line, the manner in which the Tiger King died was very interesting. The writer could tell us about it only at the end of the story, but he adds that a very interesting fact about the Tiger King's death was that when the Tiger King was born, astrologers had predicted at that time that one day the Tiger King would die. This prediction is meaningless because, as a matter of fact, everyone has to die one day. The child will grow up to become the warrior of warriors, hero of heroes, champion of champions, but they bit their lips and swallowed hard. When compelled to continue, the astrologers came out with it. This is a secret which should not be revealed at all, and yet we are forced to speak out. The child born under this star will one day have to meet its death. So the writer gives us an elaborate description of what the astrologers predicted, the time of the birth of the Tiger King. They said that the child would grow up to become a brave warrior, a hero and a champion, but after that they stopped and bit their lips in order to show their reluctance to speak. When the astrologers were forced to continue, they said that what they would reveal just now was a secret. They said that the child, that is the Tiger King, was born under such a star, which was up there in the sky, was that any person who was born at that time had to meet his death one day. Again, this prediction is meaningless because, as a fact, everyone has to meet his death one day. At that very moment, a great miracle took place, and an astonishing face emerged from the lips of the 10 days old Jillela Nizang Bahadur. Oh, wise prophecies! So, a very miracle took place at the sudden moment at that time, and the astonishing face means very wondering, very surprising circumstances created there from the lips of the 10 days voice, a 10 days infant who was merely 10 days, and a miracle is created by his mouth. And the 10 days boy spoke up. Oh, voice prophecies! Everyone stood transfixed in stupefaction. They looked wildly at each other and blinked. Oh, voice prophets! It was I. It was I who speak. This time there was no grounds for doubt. It was the infant born just 10 days ago who had enunciated the word so clearly. The chief astrologer took off his spectacles and gazed intensely at the baby. All those who were born will one day have to die. We don't need your predictions to know that. There would be some sense in if you could tell us the manner of that death. The royal infant uttered these words in his little sequence voice. So in this line, the writer says that as the astrologers revealed their secret prediction, a miracle took place. The 10 days old Tiger King, whose name was Jillela Nizam Bahadur, spoke up. All the listeners were surprised to see a 10 days old baby, yeah, infant, speak. The Tiger King called out to the wise astrologers, and the main astrologers removed his spectacles and looked intensely at the little baby. The Tiger King said, in its squeeze that all those who were born have to die one day, and he did not need their predictions to know this fact. He added that if they told him the manner of his death, that would make some sense to him. The chief astrologer placed his finger on his nose in wonder. A baby barely 10 days old opens its lips in speech. Not only that, it also raises intelligent questions. Incredible, rather like the bulletins issued by the war office. Then Fats, the chief astrologer, took his finger off his nose and fixed his eyes upon the little prince. The prince was born in the hour of the bull. The bull and the tiger are enemies. Therefore, death comes from the tiger, he explained. So, the chief astrologer was amazed to see a 10 days old baby spoke and ask intelligent questions. It was unbelievable. It was unfathomable for him, just like the news which came from the wars. He took off his finger from his nose and looked carefully at the little prince. Then he added that as the Tiger King was born in the hour of the bull, which was an enemy of the tiger, hence the Tiger King would die due to a tiger.